one sin, and yet he was kicked out of the garden. He had a whole life of sin. Father says, we are sin. Like, that's who we are, you know? But yeah, got a whole life. And the series of events led me up to the point where I was asking questions. I was opening the Bible. I was convicted that if I died, I would go to hell. I was praying. Now, I didn't pray. I didn't know how to pray. Maybe that's you. You don't know how to pray. Now, this was me. I didn't know how to pray. I didn't know why I would even pray. I trusted in myself. I was living for myself. I said, I'm going to do things my way. I don't care. If anyone tries to stop me, I'm just going to go my way, do it my way. Well, some things happened to humble me. God says he resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So I obtain grace by humbling myself, by coming to God. Because many of us think we're above God, you see. Many of us are proud and think we're our own gods. But there is one true and living God, only one. And he says, and Jesus Christ whom he sent. So there was one God, but I thought I was, my whole life I didn't obviously think about God because I was my own God. But anyway, I humbled myself and realized that, you know, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Love. I needed love. We all need love. I'm not talking about, you know, the Beatles and what they think, what they try, how they try to define love, and what, you know, the media is defining love as. No one can define love but God himself, because he is love. Anyway, it was that love that I encountered. I encountered love. I never knew love before, but I saw love in a person who was telling me and sharing the gospel with me. Love. God's love. Through his Son, Jesus, who shed his blood for me. Because I was learning that without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness. Without a sacrifice, how can you be forgiven? How can, you know, we can't right our own wrongs. We can't, you know, our good doesn't outweigh our bad. Or, you know, if we do more good than bad, it outweighs it. It's not, it can't happen. Bible says, by grace are you saved through faith. Grace is a gift. Free gift. It's God's unmerited favor. It's something we can't earn, we don't deserve. Grace, God's favor. So that's what happened. I humbled myself to obtain grace. I cried out to God. I said, God, I need salvation, God. Like, I need to be saved. I need to be saved. Save me. I was crying out to God. I was crying out to him. I was saying to my friend, how long did it take you to get saved? Like, I'm here, I'm crying out to God every day for salvation. Like, I want this guilt taken away. I want to feel like free. I need to be free here. What's happening? God. So I was crying out to him. But listen to this. One night, he answered my prayer. I was praying. This message is going to restore somebody's heart today. I was praying. I didn't pray. I was praying. And I continued to pray. I was convicted. One night he heard my prayer. He heard. My life changed. My life changed overnight. I was angry. He took the anger away. He gave me peace. I never knew peace. I wasn't born into this world with peace. I didn't have peace in my heart. I didn't have peace in my soul. But when I cried out to him, I had peace. When he answered my prayer, I had peace. I wasn't crying out to him on my own terms. You say, well, I pray, but he hasn't answered me. You're praying on your own terms. Come on God's terms. Come through his Son, repent, trust in him, and he will answer. Here's the, there's a verse that says, a broken and a contrite spirit, God will not despise. It's a broken and contrite heart. If you humble yourself, humble yourself today, because pride will take you to hell. Lucifer is proud that he is the god of this world. Everyone sees is just following this, the god of this world, and his pride. And pride, God resists the pride. You cannot come to, you won't be saved in pride. You can't be saved in pride. You need to repent. You need to humble yourself. Then you'll be saved. So that's what happened to me. I humbled myself. And he answered, humbled myself, prayed, he answered my prayer. I went to college the next day. I used to swear every time I'd open my mouth. It's funny, here's me, the one with the filthiest mouth, and God makes me a preacher. Like, the filthiest mouth, I used to swear every time I'd open my mouth, and yet he makes me a preacher, he calls me, he sends me to you guys to preach the gospel. That's just what God does. But anyway, college, I used to sweat. I'd open my mouth, I would swear. But it was like this one morning, I couldn't do it. I couldn't swear anymore. It was like I had another thought, another voice that said, that's wrong. Stop that, that's wrong. You don't need to do that. I was like, wow, convicted. So I was like, yeah, I don't want to do that anymore. I don't even want to do that. Yeah, someone's telling me, you know, someone's like convicting me, but it's like, I don't even want to do that anymore. I didn't want to swear. I didn't want to fight people. I didn't even want to feel angry or get angry at anyone. Because he came into my heart. He gave me peace. 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 The anger he took away. I had a ball of anger, even from a little kid, like a little boy, toddler, growing up. I had this anger. It was just a ball of anger, but he took that away. He took it away, and I had peace. I found peace with God. I found peace with myself. Peace. And it was because Jesus made peace through the blood of his cross. I was an enemy of God. If we are in our sins, if we are living for sin, we are enemies of God. But he made peace with the blood of his cross, so if we repent and trust in him, we can be restored back to fellowship with God. And so that's what happened. I was restored to fellowship with God. Restored.